ओके, गुड मॉर्निंग. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द सॉफ्टवेयर इंजीनियरिंग क्लास एंड द कोर्स कोड विल बी 18CS35. एंड एज यू कैन सी दिस इज अंडर द विट्यू सिलेबस एंड यू कैन सी द इंटरनल मार्क्स विल बी 40 मार्क्स एंड द एक्सटर्नल मार्क्स विल बी 60 मार्क्स एंड द एग्जाम ड्यूरेशन विल बी 3 आवर्स. सो बिफोर गोइंग टू ऑल दिस थिंग्स वी शुड नो what is the course learning objective, what is the meaning of your course learning objective is, if any subject we are learning, what is the output we are going to get from this course. So the first thing is, here we are going to outline all the principles and activities of large software programs. You know that definitely once you will learn through your computer science, definitely you want to be a programmer. So how it has to be, what will be the principles and the activities, all these things we are going to learn over here and identify the ethical and professional issues, what is happening concerning to the software engineers. That things also we are going to learn over here. The next thing is the explanations about the fundamentals of object-oriented concepts. Object-oriented concept was already been taught in your last semester as a C programming language, but here we are going to see little bit more about the object-oriented concepts. The next thing you are going to learn here, the requirements gathering, requirements classifications, requirements specifications, and the requirements validations. All these things are the process of your software models. So these things we are going to learn. And the next one will be the differentiation between the system models, UML diagrams. You can see over here, UML diagrams, the design patterns, these things. The next thing will be your testing part. In your modules, the next module, it will be having the difference, the different types of the testing. It can be your validation testing, it can be your defect testing, all these testings we are going to learn. The next, you have to recognize the software maintenance and how it has been involved in the software evaluation, how the software has been evolved. So that also we are going to see the techniques, the estimation techniques, whatever been used, that we have to see in this module. The last, you have to learn the software measurements and the metrics, how the quality standards has been increased, the practices has been increased in this module, that is known as your software quality parameters. Don't worry, all these technical words very soon you will be knowing very slowly once we will go towards our modules. Here, module wise, you will be having your 5 modules. In the 5 modules, first module will be the introduction about your software engineering, then the software process, the requirement engineering, and all these things. So these things, this part, this is a theoretical subject. You are not going to have any kind of problems, but in 3rd or 4th module you will have one problems. It is a, only one kind of problems are there, and only that kind of questions you are going to get. So it won't be that much of hectic for you to learn the problems. Only 1 or 2 formulas are there, that's all. In the 2nd module, as I told that we have to learn the little advancement of your C programming in a theoretical basis. So this module specifies that. Here, the object orientations and the models, the introduction, the modeling concept, class models, all these things you are going to learn in the 2nd module. And also in your 2nd module, the generalizations, the association concepts, and the navigations of the class models, you are going to learn in the 2nd module. The 2nd module is also very easy. This is a very easy subject. It is not going to be the difficult subject. So don't worry for how the subject will be. It is a very easy subject. The next module will be carrying out your system models, the design implementation part. The system models will be having your context model, interaction model, structural models, behavioral models, and the model driven engineering. So these all are will be your 3rd module, system models. Next will be your design and implementation part. This is your introduction to RUP. It is an important question. How to do the design? What will be your design principles? the design patterns, how to implement all these issues, the open source, what all are the softwares are available. These things we are going to learn in our third module. The fourth module will be your software testing. Once the software is ready, we have to send it for the testing. So that time, here we have many varieties of testing methods which we are going to utilize. The first one will be your development testing. Next one will be test-driven development, release testing, user testing, test automations and all. Then the next part will be the evaluation process, how you are going to evolve your softwares, and the program evaluation dynamics, software maintenance, and the legacy system management. All these things will be coming under your module 4. The last module, we have to see the maintenance and the planning, how you are going to do the planning for the projects. So here it will be the software pricing, plan-driven development, the project scheduling, estimation techniques, how the quality, what is the quality of your softwares, that management, software quality, reviews. We have to go for the inspection also, the validation process. All these things will be your module 5. If you will see your syllabus, the syllabus has been designed in a such a way that you are learning the basics of your software and you are going through slowly how to develop, how to test, how to maintain the software. So in that way, the syllabus has been designed. So if you want to do any kind of things, you have to go through this process. This is the process, one by one step you have to go. We will be discussing all in detail through the module wise. So what will be the course outcome? What the students will be able to learn once the syllabus will get complete. So here you are going to learn about the software systems, components and the process, the professional and ethical responsibility, how to build up the teams, and you are going to work on the multidisciplinary teams, then how you are going to use the techniques, skills and the modern engineering tools. That also you are going to learn in this or practice in this engineering schema. Next one will be your how you are going to analyze if any product will be given to you, how you are going to analyze, how you are going to design, how you are going to implement. So all these things are going to be the outcome of you people's, like your students. So next one is your question paper patterns. As you people know, there will be 10 questions coming in your VTU exam. Each full question will be of your 20 marks. So there will be two full questions which one will be having some four of sub questions from each module. So you have to be prepared always for the 10 marks of question, 8 marks of question, 6 marks of question and 4 marks of question. So this is the subdivision of your question pattern. The next one will be you have to answer any 5 full questions out of 10 questions. The next one, this is your textbook pattern. This is Anne Somerville, the software engineering, which is having the 9th edition. This is the latest edition of Pearson Education. And also one more book is there, Blaha book. That is your Michael Blaha, otherwise James Romberg. Book is only for your second module, that is object-oriented modeling and designing. If you want, you can refer the reference books of Roger S. Pressman. That is the 7th edition book. Otherwise, Pankaj Jalota. This book is your. This book is also there. So this is all about your syllabus copy. Now slowly we will start with the course. For how the course will be looking.